This episode of DNews is proudly brought to you by Subaru.
By Tesla, we've got it!
Wireless electricity might be coming to a home near you, you know, someday. Greetings, programs. Trace here for DNews. In 1897, Nikola Tesla, asexual genius, an inventor extraordinaire, wanted to, quote, turn the whole world into a giant wireless dynamo. He was awarded a patent in 1907 for wireless electricity, but then the Great War began and the whole thing was lost. Now, over a century later, researchers at MIT created wireless power transmission which could realize his dream. Sort of. While Tesla was trying to power whole cities, this transmits wireless power around your house. Your phone, your car, your television, your laptop, your game console, controllers, remotes, a toaster, and every light bulb in every frickin' lamp could all be powered by magnetic resonant power transmission. The Faraday law of induction describes how an electromagnet creates a magnetic field. When an electrified coil of wire is wrapped around a metal rod, the metal magnetizes. Similarly, when you pass a magnet through an unpowered coil of wire, the magnet creates electricity in that wire. Physics is awesome. Researchers at MIT found a way to turn simple physics into a wireless way to transmit electricity using a similar technology to Wi-Fi. By plugging in a resonator to the alternating current outlet in your wall, the device creates a magnetic oscillation. The magnetic field of the resonator is large enough to mingle with nearby coils installed in the walls, in the floors, and ultimately into every device. Boom! Wireless power everywhere. One magnetic coil influences another, and then another, and then another, all over the house! It's like the barking chain from 101 Dalmatians. MIT spun off the technology into a funnily named company called WiTricity. The system can already power televisions, cell phones, and keep their special AA batteries fully charged all at the same time. To be honest, induction charging isn't actually that new. It's been around for a while, as has wireless power transmission in general. Radio waves are wireless power transmission. The pads that you can buy to charge your cell phone, mouse, or game controller, that uses wireless power too. But this is a bit different. The ones that we have now use near-field induction, and this blows that out into a whole new proportion. The problem with any of these systems is the efficiency. Magnetic fields have to be relatively close by to pick up other magnetic fields. The MIT researchers were able to power one 60-watt light bulb from 2 meters away, but it was only at 45% efficiency. So they put in about 133 watts to power a little 60-watt light bulb. That is not awesome. Though, according to the researchers, this system is 1 million times more efficient than the ones already on the market, and the CEO of WiTricity says that it is 1,000 times more efficient than a regular battery. Another cool thing, this works with both old and new technology. Just because it's old doesn't mean it's not awesome. Just ask TechZilla's Patrick Norton. Pat customized 3 high-mileage Subaru vehicles for 3 charity-minded owners so they can keep doing their thing and helping the world. Check out Pat's handiwork at the Second Chance Subaru series at revision3.com/Subaru. And if you want wireless power in your house, click the like button and tell us what you'd use it for down below. We'll see you next time on DNews.